Thank you, member. The member for Kootenay West.
On January 10th, the Trail and District Library opened the exhibit Ordinary Lives, Extraordinary Times, Italian-Canadian Internment Experience. This project commemorates the experience of Italian Canadians during World War II. On June 10, 1940, Mussolini joined the war. Within minutes of this announcement, the Canadian government gave the RCMP orders to arrest Italian Canadians considered a threat to the nation's security. 31,000 were officially designated as enemy aliens. Of these, about 600 were taken from their homes and separated from their families. Viewed as fascist supporters and even spies, they were held in prisons and remote camps. None of them were ever formally charged in a court of law. They all felt the repercussions. In many cases, these events contributed to fear and hostilities in their communities across Canada, leading to loss of work, vandalism, verbal abuse, and violence. In Trail, seven men were arrested that June. Eugenio Della Lana, Armando Cecchini, Pompolino DeVito, and August Secco were all released 1 month later. Silvio Romano was not released till July 42. Victor Fabri, a lawyer whose wife and family lived in Vancouver, wasn't released until December 41. Fioravanti Tanishi, or Fred, was detained until September 43. After his release, Fred returned to Trail and in June 45 married a Canadian-born Italian, Emily, 15 years his junior, and they had 10 kids. His son, Ray, who still lives in Trail, said they fell in love in Vancouver before the war. Her mother said no. Fred was too old, the marriage couldn't happen. Fred sent Emily letters during his detainment via the priest, as he knew her mother would never let her have the letters. The mother, though, was too smart and told the priest if he got letters, to hide them. It obviously didn't work. Trail is the only community outside Toronto where the exhibit is being displayed. Although you can also go online to italiancanadianww2.ca and view stories, photos, and listen to interviews of Italian Canadians talking about how the internment affected their families. Men from Kamloops, Vancouver, and Trail, a dark part of our history that is finally being shared.
Thank you, member.